ହେଲା। ସୋ ହ୍ୟାଲୋ ଏଭ୍ରିୱାନ୍, ସୋ ଟୁଡେ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣିଂ ସ୍ମଲ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ ଫିଲ୍ଡ ଲେଭେଲ୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ। ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ମୋଷ୍ଟ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଟପିକ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଫିଲ୍ଡ ଲେଭେଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଭେରି ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ଷ୍ଟେଜେସ୍, ବିଫୋର୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ, ଡ୍ୟୁରିଂ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ବିଫୋର୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ, ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍ ୟୁ ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ କନ୍ସିଡର୍ ବିଫୋର୍ ଗିଭିଙ୍ଗ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ। ଓକେ, ଫାଷ୍ଟ ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆନାମ୍ନେସିସ୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି। ଓକେ, ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ରିଗାର୍ଡିଂ ପ୍ରିଭିୟସ୍ ସର୍ଜରିଜ୍। ଇନ୍ ସମ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ସ ହାୟର୍ ଡୋଜେସ୍ ଆର୍ ରିକ୍ୱାର୍ଡ ଇଫ୍ ଦ ଆନିମଲ୍ ହାଜ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଗନ୍ ପ୍ରିଭିୟସ୍ ସର୍ଜରିଜ୍। ଓକେ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ଏକ୍ସପିରିଏନ୍ସ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ହାଉ ଦି ଆନିମଲ୍ ବିହେଭ୍ଡ ଡ୍ୟୁରିଂ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ ଇନ୍ ପ୍ରିଭିୟସ୍ ସର୍ଜରିଜ୍। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଦ ହିଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ। ଦେନ୍ ଫିଜିକାଲ୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍, ଅଣ୍ଡର ଫିଜିକାଲ୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍ ୟୁ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଚେକ୍ ଦି ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟାଟସ୍। ଓକେ, ଦିସ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ବିକଜ୍ ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେଟ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ ରିଆକ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଦି ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ ଆବ୍ରପ୍ଟଲି। ଇନ୍ ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେସନ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ଟେଷ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ STT ଆଣ୍ଡ CRT। STT ଇଜ୍ ସ୍କିନ୍ ଟେଣ୍ଟିଂ ଟେଷ୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ଆଣ୍ଡ CRT ଇଜ୍ କ୍ୟାପିଲାରି ରିଫିଲ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। STT ୟୁ ମିନ୍ସ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ହୋଲ୍ଡ ଦି ସ୍କିନ୍ ଫୋଲ୍ଡିଂ ହିୟର୍। ଓକେ, ୟୁ ପୁଲ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଲିଭ୍ ଇଟ୍। ଓକେ, ଇଫ୍ ଦି ଆନିମଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେଟେଡ୍ ଦ ସ୍କିନ୍ ୱଣ୍ଟ ଗୋ ଟୁ ଅରିଜିନାଲ୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍। ଓକେ, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସି ଇନ୍ ଓଲ୍ଡ ଏଜ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ସ ଅର୍ ଓଲ୍ଡ ଏଜ୍ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ବିଙ୍ଗସ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ, ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ପୁଲ୍ ଦି ସ୍କିନ୍ ଅପୱାର୍ଡ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଲିଭ୍ ଇଟ୍। ଇନ୍ ହେଲ୍ଦି ଆନିମଲ୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଆଟେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ନର୍ମାଲ୍ ସାଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଏଫିସିଏଣ୍ଟଲି, ଭେରି ଭେରି ଫାଷ୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ଇଭିନ୍ ଲେସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୱାନ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ। ବଟ୍ ଇନ୍ କେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଓଲ୍ଡ ଆନିମଲ୍ ଅର୍ ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେଟେଡ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ ଲିଟିଲ୍ ସ୍ଲୋ। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଏନି ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେଟେଡ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍, ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ଫ୍ଲୁଇଡ୍ ଫାଷ୍ଟ, ଦେନ୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେସିଆ। ଓକେ, ଆଣ୍ଡ CRT ଇଜ୍ କ୍ୟାପିଲାରି ରିଫିଲ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। ୟୁ ଓପନ୍ ଦ ଡେଣ୍ଟାଲ୍ ମ୍ୟୁକୋସା, ଓକେ, ମ୍ୟୁକସ୍ ମେମ୍ବ୍ରେନ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ପୁଟ୍ ୟୋର୍ ଇଣ୍ଡେକ୍ସ ଫିଙ୍ଗର୍, ଦ ପ୍ରେସର୍, ଫୁଡ୍ ପ୍ରେସର୍ ୱିଥ୍ ୟୋର୍ ଇଣ୍ଡେକ୍ସ ଫିଙ୍ଗର୍। ଓକେ, ୟୁ ଫିଲ୍ ଫୁଡ୍ ପ୍ରେସର୍, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ବିକମ୍ ପେଲ୍, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ରିମୁଭ୍ ୟୋର୍ ଫିଙ୍ଗର୍। ଦ ଟାଇମ୍ ଟେକେନ୍ ଟୁ ଫିଲ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଦି ବ୍ଲଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋନ୍ ଆଜ୍ କ୍ୟାପିଲାରି ରିଫିଲ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ସୁଡ୍ ବି ଲେସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୱାନ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ। ଇଫ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ମୋର୍ ଦେନ୍ ୱାନ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ, ଦ ଆନିମଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡିହାଇଡ୍ରେଟେଡ୍। ଓକେ, ସୋ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ଫ୍ଲୁଇଡ୍। ଦେନ୍ ବ୍ଲଡ୍ ସ୍ଟାଟସ୍, ୟୁ ସି ଇନ୍ କ୍ଲିନିକାଲ୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍, ଓକେ, ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗୋ ଫର୍ DCTLC ହିମୋଗ୍ଲୋବିନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମାଇକ୍ରୋଫାଲେରିଆ। ହିୟର୍ ଦ ହିମୋଗ୍ଲୋବିନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏଷ୍ଟିମେଟେଡ୍। ସପୋଜ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଇଣ୍ଟେରିୟର୍ ପାର୍ଟ ହୋୟାର୍ ଦ କ୍ଲିନିକାଲ୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାଣ୍ଟ ଡୁ, ଅର୍ ୟୁ ଡୁ ନଟ୍ ହାଭ୍ ଏନି DDL। ଇନ୍ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ DDL, SBL, CIL ଆଣ୍ଡ ADRI। ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ସ ବାଇ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ହୁଇଚ୍ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡ୍ ବ୍ଲଡ୍ ଟେଷ୍ଟ। ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟେରିୟର୍ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଓଡ଼ିଶା, ମେ ନଟ୍ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦିଜ୍ ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍, ଅର୍ ୟୁ ଡୁ ନଟ୍ ହାଭ୍ ଗୁଡ୍ ଆକ୍ସେସ୍ ଟୁ ଦିଜ୍ ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍। ସୋ ବାଇ ଭିଜୁଆଲାଇଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ମ୍ୟୁକସ୍ ମେମ୍ବ୍ରେନ୍, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ଆନ୍ ଆପ୍ରୋକ୍ସିମେଟ୍ ଆଇଡ଼ିଆ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ବ୍ଲଡ୍ ଷ୍ଟାଟସ୍। ଓକେ, ଇଟ୍ ସୁଡ୍ ବି ଆଇଡ଼ିଆଲି ପିଙ୍କ, ପିଙ୍କ କଲର୍ ଅର୍ ସ୍ଲାଇଟ୍ଲି ପିଙ୍କ। ଓକେ, ଇଫ୍ ଦ ଆନିମଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ କଲର୍ ଇଜ୍ ପେଲ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଆନିମଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆନେମିକ୍। ଓକେ, ଡୁ ନଟ୍ ପ୍ରିଫର୍ ସର୍ଜରୀ ଇନ୍ ଆନେମିକ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ସ, ମେଜର୍ ସର୍ଜରିଜ୍। ଦେନ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲେନ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରି ଏମ୍ପ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଆନିମଲ୍ ସେଟ୍ ଲିଟିଲ୍ ବିଟ୍ ଲାଟର୍। ନାଓ ଫାଷ୍ଟିଂ, ଇନ୍ ହେଲ୍ଦି ଆନିମଲ୍ 12 ଆୱାର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଫୁଡ୍ ୱିଡ୍ରାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ 4 ଆୱାର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ୱାଟର୍ ୱିଡ୍ରାଲ୍। ବଟ୍ ଇନ୍ କେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପେଡ଼ିଆଟ୍ରିକ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଜେରିଆଟ୍ରିକ୍ ପେସେଣ୍ଟସ୍, ଓକେ, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ରିଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଟୁ 8 ଆୱାର୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ମେ ବି 2 ଆୱାର୍ସ। ଓକେ, ବିକଜ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଲଙ୍ଗ୍ ଏନଫ୍, ଦେର୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ହାଇପୋଗ୍ଲାଇସେମିଆ। ନାଓ ପ୍ରି ଏମ୍ପ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଆନୋରେକ୍ସିଆ, ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ମୋଷ୍ଟ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ପାର୍ଟ ଇନ୍ ଆନେସ୍ଥେଟିକ୍ ପ୍ରୋଟୋକଲ୍। ଓକେ, ଆଇ ଆମ୍ ଡିସ୍କସିଂ ଇଟ୍ ହିୟର୍, ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ସୁଡ୍ ବି ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ପ୍ରୋଟୋକଲ୍ସ। ଓକେ, ବଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଫିଲ୍ଡ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଗିଭ୍ ଆନାଲିସିଆ। ଓକେ, ଦ ସି ୟୁ ନୋ ହାଉ ପେନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ଡ। ସପୋଜ୍ ହିୟର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେସନ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ନର୍ଭସ୍, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ବ୍ରେନ୍। ଓକେ, ପେନ୍ କିଲର୍ସ ଆକ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ 2 ୱେଜ୍। ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ରିଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ଦି ପେନ୍ ବାଇ ରିଡ୍ୟୁସିଂ ଦି ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେସନ୍, ଫର୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟି ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେଟରି ଡ୍ରଗ୍ସ। ଆଣ୍ଟି ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେଟରି ଡ୍ରଗ୍ ଆର୍ 2 ଟାଇପ୍ସ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ SAID ଅର୍ ଷ୍ଟେରଏଡାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟି ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେଟରି ଡ୍ରଗ୍, NSAID ନନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେରଏଡାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟି ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲାମେଟରି ଡ୍ରଗ୍। ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ପାଥୱେ, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବ୍ରେକ୍ ହିୟର୍। ଓକେ, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବ୍ରେକ୍ ଦି ସିଗ୍ନାଲ୍ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ସମିସନ୍, these are this can be done by opioids. Opioids has many class, okay, but in case of field you can use these two drugs. This is not actually opioid, but it acts, the mechanism action is similar to opioid, that is butorphanol and tramadol. Tramadol is available in many places, okay, even in small medicine shop you will ask him, he can get you the tramadol, but butorphanol may not be available, but try to contact the nearest big shops, they can get you the butorphanol. Okay, butorphanol is a very good analgesic, also it causes some sedation, okay, so that the anesthetic protocol will be much better with butorphanol than tramadol, okay. And tramadol, the dose rate is 2 to 4 mg per kg body weight. Butorphanol is 0.2 to 0.8 mg per kg body weight. Now, you have understood which character, which parameters you should consider before giving any anesthesia. Now, this is the most important part during anesthesia. If you have attended the lecture of Dr. Indraman Nath in Odisha Veterinary College, you might be knowing ABCD. And also there is an E, I will discuss later. Okay, first one is airway. For you have to make provisions for patent airway by applying mouth gauges. If you do not have proper small animal mouth gauge, you can cut your syringe to approximate by guessing. You can judge the animal, and you see, put these between the canine teeth, the upper canine teeth, lower canine teeth, so that mouth will be wide open. Then pulling out of tongue, pull the tongue out and keep the tongue to one side so that the airway will be more patent and open. Then breathing, see, breathing is the most important in field, okay. This is very, very important, pay attention to this point. Breathing, that is respiration rate. You see, in case of dog, when the dog is anesthetized, the respiration will be from 8 to 15. It varies from 8 to 15. In case cat, 12 to 13. In healthy patients, this is just double. Okay, 16 to 30 or 16 to 20, or this can 24 to 28 or something like that. You see, during anesthesia, you have to give bolus administrations. Okay, for maintaining of anesthesia, I will discuss protocol later on. For bolus, you have to know that when the animal is getting up or when to give the bolus administration. Breathing can help you. Okay. In respiration rate, if you will see closely, in deep plane, the animal will breathe regularly. When the animal will change plane, it will take a long gasp. Okay. From deep plane to light plane, it will take long gasp. Then it will become slightly fast. Okay, that is changing from the deep plane to light plane. In that case, you will know that is the time for giving the bolus administration. For bolus administration, mostly I will talk about the ketamine anesthesia. Okay, so that is the time for giving the ketamine anesthesia. Besides that, head and tail movement. Okay, these are the signs when you will know that it is time for giving the additional bolus ketamine, mostly ketamine. Okay. Next is circulation, that is heart rate. You see, in field it is very difficult to measure the heart rate because you are the surgeon and you will giving some access to the attendant. Attendant don't know how to measure the heart rate correctly. Okay, so you may not find enough provisions to measure this heart rate, but you can make one attendant or rely some training who can measure the heart rate. Okay. Next, this is another important drugs, emergency drugs. Okay, you have to be ready with emergency drugs. Any mess happening, you can administer the emergency drug. Atropine sulfate is one of the emergency drugs. Dexamethasone, theophylline, this is respiratory stimulant. Then antidote. Okay. I will mostly discuss the benzodiazepine and alpha 2 agonist protocols. Okay, for alpha 2 agonist, you need yohimbine is partial agonist and antagonist, also atipamazole. Okay, but in benzodiazepines, flumazenil is the antidote. So be ready with antidote. It is not available in many places, you can in field you can ignore this one because it is not available most of the time. If you are getting your hands on these two drugs, keep it. Okay, it will be very helpful. Next, very important is IV line. So during anesthesia, the intravenous line should be patent. Okay, in no case the IV line should be disturbed. Okay, do not perform surgery if you do not have established the IV line. IV line is very important to even if give the emergency drugs. Okay, even if emergency drugs, then bolus administration is through IV route only. So always check for IV line in frequent manner. And I told you E is actually evaluation. With each surgery, with each protocol, you have to evaluate yourself and the protocols. Okay, that is known as evaluation. You have to continuously evaluate and improvise. Next, after anesthesia, you see, if you are using xylazine protocol, hypothermia is caused by xylazine. Okay, xylazine causes hypothermia. So you have to very careful. You have to give blankets or bedding material so that hypothermia doesn't develop, because in a hypothermia the animal will enter to deeper plane. Okay, so to prevent entering into the deeper plane, you have to provide warm bedding or warm blanket. Next is disturbances. You see, during surgery you are continuously giving pain to the animal. When you are giving the continuously pain to the animal, animal is trying to get up. After surgery the pain is not there. Okay, inflammation doesn't start just after surgery, it starts after some time. Okay, so when the pain sensation is gone, the animal will sleep more. So you have to continuously disturb the animal so that the animal will get up faster recovery. You can do blowing air to the ear. You can blow forcefully into the ear canal, it is a disturbance. You can pinch, that is tail pinching or the pedal pinching. Next is calling by name. Ask your owner to call the animal by his name or her name so that the animal will try to get up. Okay, next, fluid rate. You have to increase the fluid rate. Okay, so that the more and more drugs in system will be excreted through the urine. Okay, when the drug will be excreted, the animal will recover fast. Next, this is another important aspect, post-operative food. Okay, always advise 6 to 8 hour post recovery you have to give fluid. Okay, either glucose water or milk. Okay, do not administer any solid food. If the animal is certain level of anesthesia or in some amount of sedation, it might choke or the food may enter the respiratory system. Okay, so recovery, then also up to 6 to 8 hour, always advise for fluid, then after you can go for solid. So now we will know some protocols. Okay, you see, anesthesia means is loss of consciousness. Okay, we do not want only loss of consciousness, so we have to use some balanced anesthesia protocols. Balanced anesthesia protocol means loss of consciousness, okay, muscle relaxation, then analgesia. Okay, if you are achieving these three, then your protocol is balanced. Okay, before going to protocols, we should know some categorization of patients. Okay, category 1 is healthy patients, category 2 mild systemic disease. I am using abbreviation so that I can write fast. Okay, so this is systemic disease. And category 3 severe systemic disease, category 4 severe systemic disease, which is a constant threat. Okay, if you are not doing surgery or any intervention, the animal will die. Okay, then the category 5 moribund patient, in which if you are intervening or not intervening, the animal may die. Okay, this is category 5, this is worst condition. Okay, now protocols. Okay, I will discuss only two protocols. Okay, if you will follow these two only. First one is very popular also in college. Okay, that is atropine, xylazine, ketamine cocktail mixture. In college, this is administered at a 0.04 mg per kg. Okay, but you can use in 0.02 mg per kg body weight, xylaxine 1 mg per kg body weight, ketamine 5 mg per kg body weight, cocktail mixture. Okay, This is suitable for category 1 and category 2. Category 1 and category 2. You see, in this protocol you will find vomiting. If you have fasted the animal very well, this will not be a bigger problem. Okay. There is also another technique. Suppose in an animal you find that 20 mg is the dose. According to 1 mg per kg, 20 kg animal, and you find 20 mg per kg body weight. Okay. You increase 1 to 2 mg. Okay. Give 22 mg. Slightly higher, slightly more, the vomiting will be reduced. But I have experienced. Okay. If you increase slightly 1 to 2 mg more, the vomiting will be reduced. And also, if you are seeing any animal is vomiting, you have to put the mouth in lower position so that all the vomiters will be draining out. Okay, no vomiters will go into the trachea. Okay, after the vomiting is complete, pull out the tongue, clean the mouth completely. Okay, next protocol 2, you can use diazepam or midazolam. I prefer midazolam because midazolam is aqueous base. Okay, this one is a liquid base. Due to being the lipid base, the intramuscular injections are very much painful, okay? So you have to go for intravenous. But midazolam is aqueous base, you can administer it intramuscularly. You can use 0.2 mg per kg weight, category 3, 4 and 5. If you are using this protocol in category 1 and 2 patients, you can increase up to 0.5 mg per kg body weight. Okay. If you are not confident enough, go for 0.2 mg per kg body weight. You see, diazepam and midazolam both come in two concentrations. One is 1 mg per ml concentration, another is 5 mg per ml concentration. Okay, this 1 mg per ml concentration are good for cats. Okay, but 5 mg per ml are good for dogs because they are heavy weight animal. Suppose a patient comes of 20 kg. Okay. Then according to 0.2 mg per kg, 4 mg. Okay, 4 mg means 4 ml if you are using 1 mg per ml. So the volume will be more, okay? You have to adjust ketamine also. Okay, so you ask nearby shops to get you 5 mg per ml concentration. I prefer midazolam. Difference between diazepam and midazolam, this one is short acting, okay? It will provide this effect for 1 hour only, but this can provide 1 to 3 hours. Okay, this one is a longer acting, this one is short acting, but midazolam is 3 to 4 times more potent. Okay, so midazolam, I feel midazolam is better, and I have used midazolam in many of the animals, specifically in cats. Okay, this protocol is very good for cats. Okay, so midazolam I have got very good results. Okay, next, ketamine is 5 mg per kg body weight as usual. And now comparing these two protocols, you see analgesia is very good in this protocol. Okay, but this is moderate in this protocol. Why? You see xylaxin, this provides very good visceral analgesia. Okay, but ketamine provides superficial analgesia. So both of these combination produce very good analgesia, very good analgesia. Also the sedation is very good in this protocol. Sedation is moderate here, but sedation is very good in this protocol. Okay. Also muscle relaxation is very good in this protocol. Okay. You will find very nicely relaxed muscle. While suturing, you will know that this protocol has very good muscle relaxation, very good muscle relaxation. Okay. This one is very important. That is why I told this should be used in 1 or 2 category patient, this in 3, 4, 5. Okay, cardiovascular and respiratory dyspiration. Okay, this is very high in this protocol. Okay, so only healthy patients and with some mild systemic disease, they withstand this protocol very well. Okay, you know, many beautiful things have some disadvantage. Prettiest flower is poisonous. So this is very good protocol, but the depression of cardiovascular system and respiratory system is very high also comparing to these protocols. Okay, but in case of diazepam and midazolam, this is minimal, very minimum difference. That is why this we table for 3 and 4 and 5 category patients. Okay, 3, 4, 5 severe systemic disease with concentrate and moribund patient. Okay, next is maintenance of ketamine. You see this maintenance is 30-40% of induction dose. If you are using the protocol in 1 or 2 category patient, you can go for 40%. That is, if you are administering 1 ml in induction and 0.4 ml in maintenance. Okay, I told in the previous during anesthesia, I told that by observing the respiration and head and tail movement, you have to give bolus administration. This is bolus administration. Okay, you have to provide 40% for 1 and 2 category, 30% for 3, 4 and 5 category patient. Okay, you see 3 and 4, 5 category patient are already depressed. Okay, so you have to give the lesser margin. Okay, and besides that, I will discuss the laboratory anesthesia and bird anesthesia in next class. Then after, I will go for the large animal anesthesia. In large animal, in field condition, we do not use most of the general anesthesia, but I will discuss sedation and some particular nerve blocks. Okay, specifically you can substitute the T block and L block with paravertebral anesthesia. Okay, paravertebral anesthesia is very good. Okay, I will discuss in that also. Next class, I will discuss the bird anesthesia and laboratory animal anesthesia. You see, if you are finding any case in field surgery related, do it. Okay. Remember, before doing surgery, please be ready with surgery consent. This is very, very important. Okay. You can find in any book, ethics books or surgery books, surgical consent form. Okay, keep it printed form. Okay, this will help you very, very much. In some owners who doesn't know about anesthesia, or they do not, they want to simply fight with the doctor, keep this handy. Okay, suppose in messy happening is there, this will be your savior. Okay, always keep surgical consent and sign it before giving anesthesia. Okay, and a special request to all my veterinary fraternity, please perform surgeries when you are finding a chance. Okay, if you are afraid to use this protocol. Okay, diazepam-midazolam, ketamine. Okay, this protocol is very good, and it won't, the death reports in this protocol will be very, very less. You see, if the field starts surgery with protocols, these two protocols, then the machine, that is the college, will start with different protocols. Okay, so that we can have a multimodal approach. Okay, you see, if suppose this is a gram panchayat and there is a nearby village, how to develop the gram panchayat? Okay, develop the nearby villages. When the technology which is invented or discovered in the gram panchayat level, if you are transmitting to the village level and they are implementing it, this will be in the mode of constant invention and discoveries. More invention, more discoveries, this main body will develop more. Okay, in field level, if you will start some basic surgeries, whether it is OHE, whether it is tumor removal, C-section, or any lacerated wound, any surgeries, if will start more and more, the college or the main machine will focus on advanced surgery. They may transfer from the abdominal surgeries to thoracic surgeries. Now thoracic surgeries are very, very less. Okay, so I will request all the field beds, try to do surgeries more often. If you are getting case, do not refer to the college unless and until it is highly required. If you are finding in category 1-2 patients, please perform surgeries. Okay, only by performing surgeries we can uplift our profession, and also we can show to the higher authorities that we are capable. Okay, so we need to focus on surgeries more also. Okay, that is why I am preparing these lectures for you only. I hope you will start surgeries soon. And in my previous video, some of my commentator said that the audio is not clear, so I got the mic. I hope this time the audio is very much clear. And so this is all about today's class. Next, I will go for the bird anesthesia and laboratory anesthesia then I will go for the large animal anesthesia. Okay, thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and please share to the different groups out of state also, they can learn something. Thank you. Bye bye.